Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Carib Spice. I really appreciate you guys tuning in. It's been forever since I uploaded a video for one, and also just took a second to touch base with you on what's going on my channel or what's going on with me. So I have been really busy. I've been busy, productive. You know, I went back to work and I've been busy with that, and not just what I do at work. I also have a small business, and then I got involved in other ventures that I'm really enjoying and really focused on, that a lot of my time and energy went there. Okay, and then I also have commitments at home. You know, I have two small kids, and my kids are my everything, so I've been giving them a lot of my time. And honestly, I'll be very, very honest with you guys, like, full disclosure, on top of the pandemic, it just, the atmosphere right now in the United States, because this is where I live, felt really, really dark and heavy to me. I'm speaking to you from a personal place right now. So this to me was kind of like years in the making. That feeling that finally came over me, it kind of got bad with the whole BLM, you know, the Black Lives Matter movement, all that was going on at that time and what inspired the movement to begin with. Then recent activities, or not activities, but the recent situation at the Capitol, that felt very heavy to me. And so I just felt like, oh my gosh, you know, all this negativity, the news, just the atmosphere became too much. If you're hearing noise, like, there's a truck literally driving in front. I'm looking out, like, outside through the window, and there's a truck, like, driving by. So I apologize if you're hearing the background noise. I'm not gonna do this video again, all over again, because, whew, I need to get it done. But anyway, so with all that has been going on, I just felt like I needed to take a break. I really needed to take a break. And so, you know me, like, when I tell you I'm taking a break, I'm taking a break. I'm taking a very meaningful break, and that's what happened. And long story short, that is why I was just kind of not uploading videos. So when I say that, now I don't want you guys to assume that I have not been doing what I set out to do from the beginning. So I've been taking care of myself, working out, etc. But I just was not uploading. It takes effort to put together a video, and with two little kids sometimes, and they're very much attached to mommy, to the hip and the rib and whatever else, it can be very, very challenging just to sit down and edit, you know. So, but that doesn't mean that I have not been doing whatever. And then, you know, to be really, really frank about it, I felt very uninspired. I just didn't want to keep uploading the same sort of video. So, you know, if you give me a suggestion and I really didn't follow up, it's because I have that sort of video already on my channel. So for instance, some people would say, hey, can you do what I eat in a day? Or they would ask, how did you get back in shape after your baby? Or can you help me know how to count my macros? And honestly, I felt like for the time I've been on YouTube, I've covered a lot. So just do a quick search on my channel. I'm almost certain you will find the video there. I just don't want to keep reinventing the same concepts. You know, at some point in time, that gets really dry. I become bored with my content. I mean, imagine that. And so if that's me, then I would imagine for you. So, you know, I just think sometimes you just have to kind of gauge and know what's working and what's not working. And I think it was just best to take a break, reevaluate, and make a comeback. So hopefully this is a better comeback. Now, I've been up to some very productive things. I've been taking a lot of courses here and there since the pandemic started, like since in March, being home. I always occupy my time with being productive. So for example, I took a course on marketing with Penn State. It was an online course, and the reason why I took the course was to help me with my business, my skincare business. So, you know, when I put my products out there, I want to know how to reach new customers and build returning customers and have recurring purchases and so on. So that was very helpful. I'm getting ready to take a course in soap making. So even though I know how to make soap and I've put out some really good soap, I still feel like there's always something to learn. And maybe I'm just obsessed with the idea of learning. I think I'm a lifelong learner. Maybe that's one reason I got into teaching as well. Teaching is like one field where you teach, but you also get to learn. Okay, so I really enjoy learning. I think I'm just one of those people who'll be taking a class here and there like forever. So that was that. And then I became certified with Khan Academy. Like, I took the whole teacher prep course and all of that. And then I have started the whole Google Educator course. So I'm just trying to become a little bit more marketable. And then when Amar is a little bit older, because I'm not fooling myself right now, I know I'm just too tired, and the time that I'll need to commit to that sort of thing, it's not gonna happen now. So when she's a little older and she's more self-sufficient, I will definitely go back to school and pursue something else, probably just outside of the field of education. I'm trying to steer away from that. And that is like a piece of advice, because you feel like you have a knack for something. So my thing is like chemistry and, well, science and teaching and so on. It doesn't mean that you cannot branch off. Lately, I've been really enjoying business. You know, imagine that. It's something that I really put effort in shying away from when I was younger, especially in high school and all that stuff. I just thought that wasn't my thing. But now that I'm older and I actually have a business, I realize, oh, this could be really fun. So never just kind of have your mind set to just one thing. I'm probably just one of those people, they say, you know, jack of all trades, master of none. I'm just going to change that to jack of all trades, master of some, because if I'm doing something, I'm going to become very good at it anyway. And then YouTube, I needed to rethink my whole YouTube and then Abney's YouTube channel. I started a channel and I really have not committed very well to getting her channel up and going, but I will definitely get that going. Let's see, part of the reason I have not really been recording, I don't like recording at home. I really don't. I know I show you workouts at home and in the garage, but you don't see what it takes to do that. I literally have to wake up. I have to psych myself. I have to prepare myself and say, okay, this is what I'm gonna do, this and that. I'm gonna have Abney's breakfast prepared. I'm gonna have activities so she can do her thing by herself for a solid hour. And so that is how all of that takes place. It's not just, oh, I can go get up and film. And then I have to make sure, you know, I have the space, the physical space to do that. Sometimes, you know, things happen. You know, we're housed with children. Or even the mental capacity, the mental space. I have to be in the mood to actually work out. I don't know about you guys, but I mean, if you make videos, do you feel like you're the type of person who has to have a certain mindset to actually record a video? I'm one of those. Like, I have to put myself in that mood or frame of mind for recording. So there's so many different factors, but I really can't wait for spring and summer so I can get outdoors and really do my outdoors type workouts, because it's too cold and I can't have my kids. I have to keep an eye on my kids, you know, and I don't like recording with them in the cold. It's just, that's mean and brutal in my opinion. And I just don't like the cold. So anyway, I think that's about it. I've been doing the same things, like supplementing. I've tried some new things. I've been trying to work on my postpartum fitness and health. Believe it or not, my anxiety got so much better. So actually, I have to make a video for you guys. I feel so proud of myself. The things I used to freak out and stress about, that does not happen anymore like that. But I definitely will come back and share, because I've been getting a lot of anxiety-related questions. And I like that as well. You know, not just the fitness, but let's talk about the other stuff. And but that's it, guys. I just wanted to touch base. It's been such a while. And, you know, hopefully I can get back into a place of recording. But I wanted to keep you in the loop, and this is what Carib Spice has been up to. Check out my daughter's channel. She's young, so you know, it takes effort, but she's gonna get there eventually. And when she's older, she doesn't want the channel, you know, whatever. But I do appreciate you guys sticking on and supporting. Share some videos with some moms to be, or moms trying to get back into fitness, and let's help each other out. Okay, until next time. Peace. Bye.